Alright guys, so you guys wanted a video, lots of people were talking about this area on the map where I built a base on the last server that I played on. In my opinion, it's probably, it is the best place to build a base. In all the bases that I've built, I've tried building all kinds of different places to try and think of cool and unique ideas and stuff, and this is pretty much the best in my opinion. Don't bother commenting that this base sucks and you got a better idea. In my opinion, this is the best place. So, for starters, when you're building here, you want to turn the graphics down. The water will pulse up, but it doesn't actually kill you. If you touch the water there, as you can see, where that water is, that's where the kill wall is. But if you turn the graphics up, the water actually pulses right up into you, and it also goes down lower. So the best place I've found, I think, is to build it right about here. You want to build it above the water. You can't build under the water. If you build under the water, then as soon as you step on the foundation, then you die. So I find that you turn it up, and you find when it peaks, because it's got two different areas that it peaks. So kind of up here. And to be honest, it doesn't really matter where you place it, because it's never going to be perfect. Every time you build a base here, it's going to be a little bit different. Like, I'm going to build it right now, and it's going to end up being different than the way I originally built it. So when you get started here, it's super tough, because obviously you're not going to have all these materials. So what I like to do is, if you can have like two or three people, it's not that difficult, but if you're doing it by yourself, it might be better to just go build a one-by-one kind of off in those mountains up there or up there, but then you run the risk of somebody building here before you have a chance to build here. Because the first thing you're going to want to get done is, I'll build it how I would start it on a fresh server, is you're going to want to definitely get your one by one situated. So you're going to want to put door. To be honest, you can probably get away with doing wooden doors on the side, though it is kind of sketchy. But like I said, it's a tough spot to get started in, but if you do get started in, it pays off huge. So you might want to maybe do wood doors here on all three sides, and then go back with another foundation, and then put your furnaces here so you can get started with your metal door here. It's really good when you're starting because you can't even see it from up in the valley. So unless someone really comes to scout you or something, or they follow you home, they really can't tell you're building there. So it's a good thing to kind of farm and make sure nobody's following you before you deke down. Because as you can see, like if you're up here hitting where all the wood and the stone spawns, you can't even see it. So I think it's around three stories you can start seeing it from in the valley. So we'll go down here and just, I'll just build it and then I'll explain why I think it's so big or so good. So the most important thing, once you get your one by one set up back here, is you want to get the front wall completely done. So you'd want to go out on either side until you can't build anymore. So you can't build anymore, so that's as far back as you have to go there. And then on this side, okay, a little not as far as I was expecting, but it works. Okay, so how many foundations? Alright, six. So that's the same size as I built the last base. Six foundations. So you'll have your one by one back here. Probably the second thing I would want to start doing is just quickly get two stories of walls, and then you want to protect it from towering. So you'd quickly, I guess I'll do it. So that way everybody. So what I would probably do is I would probably just wall this. You could put a door in the back, and you don't need to put a door on it just yet. So then put your door there. And you got your one by one here. Obviously with a ceiling on top. Ceiling. Okay. So here you'd have to have wood doors, so people can't just come in and like grief you and throw their own doors on. But yeah, so I need to get this wall finished up. Now, the another good thing about this base is this front door here, you don't even have to protect yourself from griefing because nobody can place a foundation in front of it because of the angle. So on both sides, they can't. So you'd want to throw a door here and here. And then I like to just leave a space, and then I'll throw a door there. And then a door there. So there's like, so then you'll have to place a foundation here. You'll have to check where. Sometimes it differs. Sometimes you can place a foundation there. So you'll want to place a foundation in front of that. And we kind of lucked out here and in front of there. So another thing you'll want to do is you actually want to go out one this way as well. And one there. And this will just protect your base from being towered up on. To be honest, you don't need to build here. Because even if they were to tower up there, they could not see for the wall. So they could tower up and get on top of your base, but they could tower up out here and get on top of your base, really. But for the amount of wood, I would just go and do it. And then it's going to be kind of tricky to place the pillars all the way up because you're going to have to do some parkour stuff. But yeah, so it can't be placed anywhere else. So there. So the front of your base is done. Now you have to full pillar it. Don't be that guy that just leaves the center, like puts pillars in the middle and thinks you're safe, because you need to full pillar or else you're just going to get pillar barricaded on and you're going to wake up and, well, stuff probably won't be gone if you spread it out, but it's going to be super easy to raid the base. So you full barrier or full pillar it. So I'll just leave it like that. You obviously go full height with those, so you're not going to just leave them at one floor. As high as your building is, you need to have all your exterior pillars match that. So these corners in here, if you go in there, you die. So you don't go in there. So do. Oops. I'll just throw doors on here. And then... so I'm just showing in stages. The stages, in my opinion, are probably the best, but it differs for every different occasion, obviously. You may do one thing, and then the one thing that you leave open, they use to get in. Okay, so that's stage two. You got yourself protected from people getting in. They can still get in if they really want to, but they'd really have to put in a lot of materials and it probably wouldn't be worth it for them. So they can't just simply come in and barricade over. So they'd have to actually staircase outside of your stuff. Probably wouldn't be worth it. So there, that's stage two done. Now the next thing you probably want to do, I find it really important for me, especially streaming. For you, it might not be as important because you can kind of build your stuff sneakily and not have to worry about anyone. Is that even a word, sneakily? Griefing your stuff. So you want to get the ceilings down. Once the ceiling's down, you're pretty much good to go and you can't really be griefed. So you want to get the ceilings down. And then now is when you figure out how big your base is going to end up being. And every time you build it here, it's going to be different. Like there's. So you see where you can place foundations. Place them here. Here. Not there. Okay. This is going to end up being really small considering what I thought it was going to be, but that's good. It'll save materials in the end. You'll want to go back with this one as well. Okay. There. So it ended up being a giant wall with 3x3 in the back with a couple random notches stuck out. I would have preferred it to have been able to be full size here. So like one of these foundations, but just sometimes it's not in the cards. Okay. Now the first mistake I did when I first built here is I took these foundations and went all the way back to like here with them. You don't want to do that. You want to just leave it there. Same with on this side. You could keep going back. Don't go back. Especially, I mean, even if you don't want to build a metal base, you can eventually just build a second wood base back here. But that's why this spot is so strong, is because you can use your wood base to protect your metal base. So then you would just continue this as normal. I'll just mock up one floor really quick so we can carry on. The staircase back here. These spots right here are actually really good for windows. Didn't work out as good as my last one, but you can kind of just peek around and see. This spot actually might have been a better spot for a window, though less people come over there. So you can throw windows in wherever you see fit. Finish this. Okay, so one more pointer, just kind of basic things that you don't think of when you're building the base, and then once you build it, I know for me it annoys the heck out of me, is doorways. Lots of people don't even think about where they're placing their doorways, and then the hinge ends up being on the wrong side, and it drives you nuts when you're trying to move through your base quickly. So, I'll do two staircases. I'll use right here as a mock-up for two separate staircases. Okay. Wall them. Okay. So one option, people just place the door, they don't pay attention. That's going to be a really annoying door to open, and you're not even going to realize until you throw the door on it. What you want to do is you want to see where that 45 degree angle board, you always want to have it on the left when you're walking into the staircase and when you're walking out of the staircase at the top. Boom. Same with when you're building metal, you want to have the tin. You can see the orientation of where the tin is, and you want to have the tin facing outwards. You place that there. And then on this one, I'll purposely do it wrong. And then on this one, I'll do it right. Okay. So now, throw the doors in. And who knows, this may not bother you as much as it bothers me, but it drives me absolutely insane when I'm trying to move through my base really fast and doors. So this is an example of a annoying door, or in my opinion, a wrong door. You open the door, and you have to like crouch through, or you have to like crouch through to get through like that. So basically, you have to walk into your staircase, close the door, then go around. Then same here, you have to open this door. It's not as important this way, but so you open the door, and you have to like turn this way. This is turning into like just min-max OCD. But okay. So say you're wanting to go down the stairs now. You have to open the door and turn left, close the door, then turn right to continue down. So for that good door, you're going to open it and be able to just start walking up the stairs and then just close it as you're walking up. And same thing when you're walking down, you're going to be able to open it, and you're already going to want to be turning right to go down the stairs, so you can just hit the door as you're walking down. It's one of the little things it's when you just take the couple seconds to make sure you put your doors in the right way, you're going to be thanking me. Okay. So, boom. That's the main structure here, which is just, if you intend on building a metal base, you can't beat it. You literally cannot beat it, because for the most part, if you build a wood base, then transition to your metal base, your metal base is strong, but it's just a metal base. This way, you transition to a metal base, and it's protected by your wood base. So for one, if anybody wants to get close to your metal base to scout it, they can't. And if they want to raid your metal base, they have to use C4 on your wood base to go through to the metal base. So for this one, they'd have to go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 walls. So they'd have to go through 10 C4 just to get to this point right here where the metal base would be started. Granted, obviously, your wood base is tall enough that they can't just go over. You got to go like 6 stories with this, and then they can't fall in the back without dying. Okay, so I'm going to make it out of wood. But obviously, you'd probably want to make this out of metal. You'd want to build your wood base up as tall as you can, as big as you can. You can go farm factory. Factory's really close to this location. Big Civ's really close to this location. So you can farm them until you get all the metal pieces. And then you can, once you're ready, you got about 1,000 low-quality metal saved up, you can start building your metal base. So when you want to build here, I've experimented a couple different ways, but you want to line the left side of the foundation up kind of with that peak, this peak right here. Hold on, let me change it to new again so you guys can actually see what the hell I'm doing. Okay, so yeah, I've tried building straight back this way, and you can only really build one foundation because of the way the island works. So you're going to want to start here and as far back as you can, as close as you can to your building. So here, and I ran into this last time. It's not going to let you place the foundation. It's green. You can click all you want. It's not going to let you place it. So what you want to do is you want to walk over here and place it with the same orientation, but just angle your body differently. So it's kind of tricky trying to line it up when you can't see where the heck it's going. But you want to get as close as you can to the wood. And make sure it's lined up the same, and then bam, it'll let you click it. So now, you can place there, there. And you can actually go really big with this, like super big. This is actually going to end up being the exact same size as the last base that I built. It's identical. So on the last server, this is how big I was able to make my battle base. It's a 2x4, and then it's got a 2x1 stick out on the side. So one thing that I messed up on mine when I was building it, I'll show you guys so you don't do the same mistake I did. I'll just tower this up. Okay. Is, I guess I'm not really going to be able to demonstrate it. You'll have to trust me. Where I put this wall here, if somebody were to tower up to the top of your wood base, or even C4 through, say they wood gatewayed into the third floor of your wood base, they blasted all the way through, blew this back wall up, they can place an angled barricade like this. That. Where can I put a staircase here so I can just easily get on top of that? And they would be able to C4. They could walk all the way out to the corner, and they would be able to C4 the corner of this. So they would automatically, whatever floor they chose to go through on the wood base, they would automatically have access to that on your metal base. So when I did it, I obviously wasn't thinking about it, so I just full boxed this in because it's protected from towering. Like you can't tower anywhere back here. It doesn't. Oh, okay. So you could build there. Okay. So you'd want to. So if that was the case, you'd want to build there. Oh wow. You can get really close. Okay. Well, that didn't go as planned. So you'd want to pillar this. You'd have to pillar this to protect yourself. Or else they just tower up on yours. Now this is going to take a lot to do because you're going to have to tower up, do. You're going to have to do this. Then you're going to have to do some parkour from the top of this base and jump over across. Okay. So because you got that pillared now, now you can build this full size. So you would build this like you would normally build a base, except for on that corner right there. I'll just do the front half. So this door might be somewhat difficult to get in. You might have to do some crouching to get in, but it's not the end of the world. Okay. Oh, you actually don't have to crouch at all. So you can just walk right in. Okay. Now on this corner here, pillars everywhere. Just pillar the whole thing. So what that's going to do is if they do get access to the wood base, they can't just C4 their way into the metal base. They're going to have to go through the bottom. I mean, they could get through the third floor if they did some gateway stuff, but for the most part, it's not really that common that somebody would do that, but you still want to protect yourself from it. So now the metal base, we're imagining this is metal, is going to be completely protected. If they do blast their way in, they're going to have to go through the bottom. And if they do tower their way up to the top of the wood, well, then they're going to have to go through the top. So you just build your metal base back here. You keep building your wood base up with your wood. And pretty soon you get a humongous complex that is pretty much, quote-unquote, unraidable. Somebody's going to look at it, and they're going to just visually assess it, and it's going to be so not worth the amount of C4 that they're just going to leave it, and you're going to be smooth sailing. So, yeah, this is it. You guys want to see exactly where it is? It's on, right on the ocean side of Coast Valley. There's actually quite a few resources that spawn right up in this area. So it's actually good. You can leave your base, go farm a little bit, even if you don't really want to play that much. Go back, drop the resources off. Factories that way, big sieves that way. And one thing that you can do also is once you kind of get established here, if you want to make it even quicker to get your metal pieces, you can go and build a 1x1 or just a little 1x2 over by factory, and you can just use that to farm animals over there. And then when you get your metal pieces or research kits or anything you want to drop off, you just run it over here, drop it off at base, and you're set. So there's that. What else can I cover? I'm going to try and just make this kind of a all-in-one, all of my general knowledge of base building. Share it with everybody. Oh, okay, let's do this. Wood. Give me a sec here. I gotta spawn myself some wood. Okay. Myself 1,000 wood. Oh man, I don't have the blueprint, so I'll just spawn myself the item. GG. I'll do 10 large storage. Okay, that is how you spell it. GG. So one thing you do not want to do, and if you watch my stream, you'll have seen it, is put all your crates in one room and not have any crates anywhere else, even if you can't see them on the outside, because a hacker's going to see where all your crates are, and he's going to just go right to where they are, and you're going to log back in, and you're going to be like, how the heck did he know where all my loot was and went straight to all my loot? It's because he's got ESP, and he can see where all your crates are. So if you're on my stream, you saw that in this corner room, I messed up and didn't put the pillars there. So what I did was I made it look like fake loot rooms. So I loaded it with crates, and then I completely boxed it off. I came back, a hacker had jumped to the top of my base, C4'd into my metal base, into the fake loot room, and got absolutely nothing. So if you, for instance, have in here just lined with crates, there's like 4 crates in here, boom, no crates anywhere else, well, a hacker walks by, he's going to instantly know that this is where all your loot is. So he's just going to blow through that door, and he's going to have everything. So what you want to do is, I'll spawn some more, so I have can demonstrate it. If I can spell. Is you want to put crates in every single room. So you put a double crate in here. You can put a double crate in here. You can put a crate here. And these are all going to be blocked off. You don't want to leave any open spaces in your base. You'll be blocking all this stuff off. Excuse me. Another thing you don't want to do is you don't want to just throw doors everywhere. Excuse me. Because it's extremely expensive to put doors everywhere, and it's not necessary. Plus, you'll find yourself getting lost in your own base, which is kind of annoying. So, I mean, put a wall here, like, save some resources, just put a wall there. Same thing here, you don't need a door here, put a wall there, and put a doorway here. Back here, obviously, you're going to need to put doorways so you can get through, but you don't need to have every single thing doorway. Because it's going to get extremely expensive. So obviously you're going to want to fill these with metal doors once you get enough resources, but... So then you're just going to fill it up with crates. One crate in every single room. They don't even have to have... You don't even have to keep anything in them. Just put a crate in every room. Put one in here. One in there. So now, when the guy looks at the base from the outside... Hey, you could even make this side super juicy. You could just line this room with crates. Completely just make it. If somebody looks through the cracks on here, they're gonna be like, "Oh wow, look at how many crates are there." Blow through, all empty. So hey, just put crates down. Don't even put anything in them. Don't fill all your crates up, and then when you don't have any more room, build a wood crate. You just want to have a ton of wood crates, and they're not going to know where any of your stuff is. So that's another really important tip. So now that you got all your loot spread out, another important tip is barricading walls. I kind of got these staircases here, so it's going to be kind of hard for me to do, but you want to barricade walls on the outside so people cannot see through. Only really necessary on the first two floors, maybe three if you really want to go with it, but so then, for example, I'll show it here. I'll make it daytime again. Time. So say you put I'll just line this with crates. Just fill it up with crates. I'll do the same on this other side, where I don't have any barricades. Now when somebody looks through there, they can't see anything. All they can see is barricades. Yeah, they can't see nothing. They look over here. All they see is crates, and they're gonna just blow through that wall, and you're gonna be hooped if you had anything there. That's another important tip. What else can we cover here? Yeah. That's probably it. I'm probably gonna think of something after, and maybe I'll like throw up another short video showing some more stuff, but that kind of covered it all. So, I mean, we got doorways, and the way you wanna place doorways. The 45 degree angle board on the left hand side when you're entering the stairs, and then when you're exiting the stairs at the top. You want to protect yourself from everything. You gotta try and look at it. You gotta try and think 10 steps ahead of everybody. And it's super hard. You're gonna like do something, and then as soon as you do it, you're gonna be like, damn. I screwed up. Hopefully the guy that inevitably raids me will not see my one screw up that I had. Another thing you can do is here, you can, even if you have, it's easier to place the cades when you don't have doorways, but you can actually still place them. What you do is you go on this side, and you place it as far as you can, and it goes to pretty much the edge of the doorway. They can't really see in. They can a little bit, but you're not usually not going to put any crates in there because there's not really any room anyways. And then you do the same thing on this side. And there's a gap in the middle, but yeah. So, yeah. So, this is where the base is. This is my ultimate. If I were to build an ultimate base and call it the unraidable base, by unraidable I mean as difficult as you can possibly make it to raid a base, this would be it. Because, for example, if they were to go through the wood base, 10C4, and then they were if this were metal, it would probably take them 30C4 to get back to this foundation, roughly, for one floor. So say this is 5 floors, they're going to have absolutely no clue where your loot is, and they're not even going to try it. They're going to go hit that 1x1 over by Big Civ because it's probably going to be stacked with loot, and all they're going to have to use is 2C4. So you can basically sit here and you can go to sleep at night knowing, for the most part, all your loot's going to be safe. So, yeah. If you got any questions, put them in the comments below. I'll try to answer them. Or just come by over on Twitch and ask me there, and we'll see. Hopefully Rust starts adding some updates, because for the most part, it's kind of getting dry, and I think everyone feels like they've kind of done everything they can do, and it's not really going anywhere. So, we'll see. So, talk to you guys later. See you later. Peace.